was playing somewhere a couple of years ago, and someone showed up after the show, and she brought me a copy of my junior high school yearbook. And moved to where was I? Muskogee, Oklahoma. It was my first year there in seventh grade. I was there because my folks moved there. I might not have gone if I didn't. Especially if I'd known what that first year would be like. And I said thank you, but I was lying. And I opened this thing up, and actually, I got a big kick out of it. There were, they all were, you know. I stayed there for about 3 years. It was long enough to. You know, make a mess of things and have to move once again. And as I leaf through this thing, I found a picture of this girl that I've been talking about ever since, named Julie. And I remembered that in the first week or so, this was in the summer that I arrived in this town, I was approached by a couple other denizens of the neighborhood, at least as short as I, well, no, not nearly as short as I was. I was really shrunken up for a very long time. They said they wanted me to come over to a party in somebody else's backyard. I said, okay. Which was really out of character for me then and now. Usually if I'm invited somewhere, I run like a scalded ape as far away as I can. The guitar came along just at the right time, because you can't do that too often without running out of options and basically weathering up like King Tut, you know, in the bottom of your own self-made tomb. And I went over to the house, and I was told to select between two girls, Julie and Sammy. I'd not done this in Cheyenne. I didn't want to do it in Muskogee, and I didn't even know what they're talking about, really. My only kiss up to that point was from my grandmother, and I didn't want that again. You know, I mean, it was nice, but no thanks. Life was difficult for me, I guess. I wouldn't have it any other way, is what I know. And as it turned out, a kiss was how I was going to make my choice. I didn't, you know how you did this. And Sammy threw me to the ground. Sammy, not Julie, threw me to the ground and kissed me. And my grandmother never looked better. Is this what this is all about? Wow. And then she got off me, and Julie jumped on me. Knees right here. It hurts. And to think of somebody in that at that angle reaching down and kissing you is hard to imagine. How did that may have had something to do with the quality or the affect. That's a better way to put it, that I was left with as a result of Sammy's attempted prehensile lip trying to kiss me. Probably just collided with my forehead or something like that, about as far as it could reach. You know what I mean? Julie had no problem. She could have hung from a tree with her lips. Knocked me out. I was shaking. I was thrilled. I was, you know, fireworks, stars, the night crawlers were coming up out of the dirt. And I stood up after Julie got off me, and I can't explain this. I couldn't then, and I can't now, and I picked Sammy. I So this song is, I was trying to exorcise this whole experience playing out what would have happened had I followed my feelings or whatever I was following and selected Julie. Given the way I actually handled everything, this is how it would have turned out. I climbed the hill to Julie's house, the place I used to live. I climbed the steps and tried the door and let myself in. The kitchen clock I used to watch had stopped at 5 to 5. A photograph I'd never seen. A car came up the drive. I stood outside the kitchen door, and when she turned her head, I said that I was back to stay. She laughed at what I said. She said that I'd grow old, believing I was what mattered most. And I'd uncover real feelings when I got close. Julie's house, the place I used to live. I climbed the steps and tried the door and let myself.